co-host is. Well, anyway, our next guest is the original wild thing of country music. Her stormy romances have been common reading in the tabloids for years. Well, today her world has been changed with the welcome of addition of her two kids and her new hit single, Some Kind of Trouble. Let's take a look.
Late one night I heard a knock on my door. No surprise, it was my landlord. Notified me I was late with the rent. What can you do when your last dollar's spent? You got trouble.
Some kind of trouble, my middle name.
What kind of trouble?
Well, no. We're really excited about this new song. Mm-hmm. It's the third single off the album, and the album is called Without You, What I Do With Me. And the third single is Some Kind of Trouble, along with a new video. And I was really excited about it, too, because I was saying to the gal backstage when you were showing the clip, a lot of my girlfriends are in the video.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, a lot of my friends, period, are in the video. So it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun.
So you got started when you were 13.
Yes.
What is that like?
Well, a lot of things have changed since way back then. Uh-huh. I mean, you know, now you have a number one record and you've got three buses and a road crew and making $50,000 a night, you know. Back then it was a lot different, and a lot of people wondered if I had lost any of my childhood years.
Mm-hmm.
But I have to tell them, I tell them every time I've gotten to do so many wonderful things that probably a normal 13-year-old kid wouldn't be able to do.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like very, well.
Who did you meet?
Well, who did I meet? Well, just anybody.
Now,
I mean,
what is this about you and Elvis? Did you meet Elvis then?
Well, I met him when I was 17.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I always loved the name Presley. I mean, I named my little girl Presley after Elvis. But I had her named long before she was even really thought of, you know. Of course, I knew I'd have children one day, and of course, I named my new little boy, he's 4 months old, after my dad.
Tell me the story of the night he was born. That's such a great
story.
Well,
the night before he was born, I went into the hospital, and they were going to induce me the next day, next morning. So I called Clint Black and was talking with Lisa Hartman. Clint answered the phone is what happened, and he said, well, I'm going to be giving that award out tomorrow night for Female Vocalist of the Year, and I said, well, that's great, Clint. And he said, well, I hope I get to call your name. And I said, well, that would be wonderful, too.
But I'll be busy.
But, yeah, I think I'm going to be a little busy. I said, I'm having a little baby boy, and I'm going to name it after my dad. And that was the end of that. Well, the next day, I had the Bo Grayson at 1 o'clock, 1:10 in the afternoon. And about 8:30 that night, I was laying there in bed. And
in pain.
Clint Black says, Tanya Tucker, who's watching from the hospital room, has just named her little boy after her dad. My dad did not have any idea that I had named my son after him, so he fell off the couch, you know.
And you won the award.
And then when Roy Rogers said baby and all, I thought, well, now what's Reba doing with her baby now? You know?
Reba again?
Got a record deal or what, you know? No, it was when Roy Rogers said my name, and that was also a wonderful thing because Roy Rogers is a hero of my dad's and of mine.
What a nice
night. I hope I have several other nights just like that.
Yeah.
One.
Now I have to ask you a personal question.
Oh, well, that's all right.
Like I wouldn't, you know. Why didn't you marry the baby's father? Both your children, same man.
Right.
Why didn't you ever marry him?
Well, I think that that's probably a long story. I mean, we got three, four minutes. Well, actually, I'll give you all I can. I guess the point, make a long story short, is that we didn't give it time to, we met, we fell in love, and we really didn't have time to be in love.
Mm-hmm.
And in the process, I got something that I'd been wanting for a long time, and that was to have a child.
Mm-hmm. But then you did it again.
Well, we tried to get back together. Seems like every time We break up. I get pregnant.
I see. It wasn't planned that way.
No. It really is a hard story to tell.
You're going to have more kids?
Yeah.
You're going to get married?
But I don't know. You know, we're still very, very good friends, and who knows? I mean, we may get together again. I don't know.
You might marry him?
I'm not saying I'll do or won't. I mean, I will say that I'm just going to try to be happy, and I think that's the most important thing, is because I was thinking that today coming in on the plane. I said, you know, it's really important that you think every minute, even the bad times, even when I'm feeling tired right now, I like to be home in bed. But,
sorry.
Just kidding.
With
I'm
who?
Seriously kidding. No, I'm tired, but I'm glad to be here. And I'm, but you know, you have to learn to really accept and enjoy and be happy, whatever that takes.
You told me backstage what would make you happy.
Yeah, 6'2".
Rich guy, old with a cough.
Rich, old, and got a bad cough.
Can I ask about Glenn Campbell? Is that still a very touchy subject?
No, I don't think so. It never has really been very touchy with me.
Really? I mean, you guys said some vicious things about each other.
It's unfortunate that people have to, like us, have to live our lives in
still
the limelight.
Public.
Mm-hmm. But, you know, we chose that kind of life. So I think that when you choose a certain way of life, you have to learn how to deal with it.
Mm-hmm.
And you can't accept just the good. You got to take the bad along with it. And nobody's life here, anyone here has got a rosy life all the time.
And you wouldn't want all of it publicized? I agree with that one.
And it's a shame, though, but still, and I think it probably really does crucify a lot of relationships. But it's hard, period. It's hard. Life's hard, but it's also very wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just, you know, I think the good Lord's on my side, and I think that if there's a person out there that is the one that's for me, then I'm sure that He'll make it, I don't know, he'll make me go through San Jose or something, I don't know.
You said, you know, that you had to grow up fast. Do you think you missed something along the way about men, learning something about men? And in this business, men will take advantage of you in the music business, I would think.
Well, I think they take advantage, well, I hate to say men, because that's like, women take advantage too, you know, I mean, it's just, men take advantage of women vice versa. I mean, everybody.
But in the music business,
I think it's probably a little more concentrated. But, you know, everybody has that to a point.
Mm-hmm.
And you just have to, I think, what is it, stay true to your goals and stay honest with your dreams and just keep on moving on.
Thank you.
Don't let nobody get you
down. Thanks a lot. Thanks for coming
by. All right.
Still ahead, why will Oprah never get on a scale again? Find out with Cindy Adams. And chocolate is everybody's weakness, but we'll show you some chocolate recipes you won't believe.